was one time I really wanted revenge. Revenge. I'm telling you right now, boy, I hated that guy so much. And I got it. Got it good. See, I had a snowball in my home. And I was going to hit the barrel with a snowball. The barrel was coming down the street. I was laughing to myself because I know how funny Harold is. See, every time you hit him with a snowball in the face, blop, he always says the same thing. Says, "Hey, man, what you want to hit me in the face with a snowball for?" You know, and I just never. So I'm just waiting for him, man. I got this light, fluffy snowball, you know, ready to hit him. And that's the rule of the game. You cannot hit a kid in the face with a slush ball. Slush ball is, it has ice and water and gunk all in it, you know. And you can't hit a kid in the face with it. You cannot drop in his open galoshes either because it sends him home. You know, hey, what do you want to drop in his galoshes for? So, I'm tickled to death, man, because I know it's a prop. Hey, man. And he's about 3 feet away, and I raise up to hit him something. Pow! On the side of the face, and it was stinging. And all the juice ran down in my underwear and everything. And it was ice all in my ear. Somebody hit me on the side of the face with a slush ball. And I looked around with one eye, and there's old Junior Barnes just laughing. Ah! Thank you. Junior Barnes was sitting on the steps in front of my house. I was standing there with him. I had gone to great lengths to prove to Junior Barnes that I was his greatest friend. Let him drink out of my orange soda bottle without even wiping it off. And old Junior Barnes just sitting there telling his little jokes. And I was laughing right with him. Junior Barnes, you are so funny. And I said, Junior Barnes, I'm going to the house and get an orange soda for us. You just wait right here. You gunky. And I walked in the house and opened that freezer door, and my mother had thrown the snowball away.